Hey. All right, Lowell. It's that time of the month again. You know what that means. It's the third Thursday of every month, and I am your host, Maximus Sack, and I'm here with Emred Dunner, and they're going to take it away. They're going to take it away and send us to another land. See ya.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We'll be right back. gentlemen. You're watching the LTC Sessions. My name is Seth, and I'm here with the featured band of the month. And Riley, you're going to have to tell me how to pronounce your band name.
Emre Dane.
Emre Dane. Emre Dane Group. And yeah, these guys are awesome. I caught them at the back page a few weeks ago, and I said, I got to get these guys on the LTC Sessions. So here we are. What does Emre Dane mean? I need to be enlightened. I think our listeners need to know.
So Emre Dane means time changes, essentially. It's a Ghanaian Adinkra symbol from West African culture. And it symbolizes like an hourglass, or it's symbolized by an hourglass. And basically means to flow with life's changes, because time kind of changes everything inevitably. And in Emre Dane Group, we also like to play with the time. We do some weird time signatures. We like to get a little out there. So it was a good play on words, too.
Yeah, I was hearing that you guys are really into the rhythmic aspect of music. The last song I think you played sounded like it might have been an odd time tune, but it was really just four, but with heavy syncopation. So, yeah, that's great. Emre Dane. Now, can you tell me a little bit about where you guys are from or how you met? And I'll pass the mic this way over to Tim. Why don't you tell me a little bit about that?
Okay. I met Riley at UMass Dartmouth, where we were both music majors. Also from UMass Dartmouth, Ben Paulding and Marcus, both alumni. Since then, I've been playing with Riley for a long time. And actually, Riley, do you want to tell the story about how we met Sam?
Sam wants to tell the story.
All right, we're going to pass this to the bass player, Sam.
So I'm the odd man out. Everybody else went to UMass Dartmouth, and I'm currently a student at the University of Rhode Island. And I went into one of my bass lessons one day, sometime, I think it was about this time last year, and my teacher, Dave Zeno, comes up to me. He's like, "Hey, Sam, what are you doing on Monday?" And I said, "I don't think I'm doing anything. You want a gig?" I said, "Yeah, sure." So he gave me Riley's number, and he said, "Give him a call, and you'll figure it out." And went and played at the Poor Farm Tavern in New Bedford and played a bunch of cool tunes. And I'm like, "Yeah, I like these guys." And I think these guys were like, "Yeah, we like him too." So we kept playing, and eventually it like kind of assimilated into a band. And we now have this awesome band that I get to play with and make music with, and it's pretty cool.
Sweet. So yeah, that's the story of Sam, Riley, Tim, and then did you go to Dartmouth too, Marcus?
I did, long before then.
Oh, okay. And how about Ben?
Yeah, I did.
As well. UMass Dartmouth, rock and roll. Great. Why don't you guys tell me a little bit about your plans for the summer? Do you have any cool shows coming up? Are you gonna record? Are you gonna tour Japan? I wanna know where we can see you, where we can find you, and what to expect.
After we're done with Haiku Camp, we're doing the rest of our album. We're in the middle of mixing like a little EP, and then we're going to eventually be recording some more tunes. And let me see, what do we have for the summer? I'm trying to think.
We got that New Hampshire thing.
Yeah, next week we're playing in Rhode Island at AS220 for the Is This Jazz series. We're playing with Sam's teacher, Dave Zeno, who's opening for us, and his son, and they're doing a dual upright bass performance called Bass Off. It's going to get real raunchy real fast. Yep. And it should be a good gig. We have a few things in Cambridge and Somerville over the summer as well, and maybe Gratitude Festival if they have it this year. And besides that, it's all online. We're on Facebook, you know, Emre Dane Group, if you can spell it. Emredane Group.
Yeah, very nice. Is that your main website?
Yeah.
Kind of? All right, Facebook/Emredane Group. Check them out. I think we should get back into the music. So it's good checking in, and check them out at AS220. That's what, next week?
Yeah, next Tuesday.
Next Tuesday. That's in Providence, Rhode Island, so check that out. I just want to remind you, you're listening to the LTC Sessions on Channel 8, and If your band wants to be featured on the show, send me an email, sessions@ltc.org. Send me a demo, and we'll get you in there. We got some openings this fall. Next month, we have Surprise Party, Power Trio Gone Quartet, actually. So that'll be good, some rock and roll. And then, no, excuse me, they're playing August. Next month is Magic Island. So stay tuned for Magic Island from Worcester/Leominster-Lunenburg area, I think. Another quartet, rock and roll, and Surprise Party in August. So, yep, big ups to our crew, the sound crew, video crew, and the Last Safe and Deposit Company for hosting the show. If you guys are watching at home and you want to get out and go downtown and check out the show, head over to the Last Safe. They got a plan on the TV. And tonight, they got a pretty awesome show, Big Sway and Pile. And I think another band called Vomit Face. You really want to see them now, don't you? Yeah. So, but Pile's great. Big Sway's great. We had them on here, I think, in 2 months ago. It must have been April. So, yeah, we're going to get back to the music. We're going to show another short video and get Emre Dane to close it out till 9. So you're watching the LTC Sessions. Stay tuned and take it away, production crew. Thank you.
Across.